Hello? Oh, hey Jason, what's up? Yeah, I remember that, yeah. Yeah, you, wait. How did. What the hell do you mean you left your shoes in my apartment? Yeah, okay, yeah. Look, I'll get them, okay? Just wait, I'll get them. Okay. Bye. Hello. So today is Christmas, and I feel like around this time of year, people kind of get into this sort of state of like reflection. You know, where people look back on the year to see how it went, what things have changed. And I think I speak for everyone just a little bit when I say that 2023 has sucked a lot. So, I kind of wanted to make this video sort of for myself, which I'll get into here in a minute. Just kind of going over some things that happened this year that have made it pretty rough, but also kind of going over a few things that weren't too bad or things that were positive, you know, stuff like that. And the reason why I'm making this video is because there's a YouTuber that I really like. His channel's called Sagan Hawks. He's a really good YouTuber. If you're into like horror video game content and analysis and stuff like that, I highly recommend checking out his channel. He's really good. I'll put a link in the description below. But anyway, one of his more recent videos was, you know, your standard run-of-the-mill Sagan Hawks production, but at the end, he went on this little speech about how, and he was referring to the horror game he was, you know, looking at, analyzing. He was talking about how perfection is the enemy of good. Because as a content creator, when you try to make things perfect, they never actually turn out perfect. There's always, I mean, you can't make something perfect. But if you keep trying to make it perfect, you're never gonna get there. And I feel like that kind of is apt for someone like me, because for this past whole year, I've been wanting to upload more videos onto this channel, but I just haven't because, not because I don't have the time, I do. But the problem for me was that every time I would try to think of, you know, a video idea, I just didn't want to do it because I thought it would end up sucking. When in reality, even if it did suck in the end, at least I had made something and put it on the channel. Because that's what I like to do at the end of the day, is make stuff for people. So that speech he gave really kind of struck a chord with me, and that's kind of why I'm sitting down recording this right now, because it's at least something to put up on the channel. I feel like this year has been tough on me. You know, my health isn't doing that great. Well, I mean, it's not bad, but it's worse than where it was before. I have a new job, which is good, but, you know, I actually kind of liked my old job a little better in certain ways. I'm kind of trying to adjust with that. I moved into a new apartment, which is awesome, but I don't really like living here. You know, it's so far away from where I work and where everyone I know lives. Like, it's such a pain to get to other places because of how far away I live from everywhere. I'm like 30 minutes away from, like, my parents' house, which wouldn't be a problem, but, like, that house is the closest thing to where I live. So you can see how that would get monotonous really fast. I've had people, loved ones, pass away this year. And it's tough to deal with that. You know, I feel like a lot of times you're just trying to keep that in the back of your, like, push it to the back of your head and not think about it, but it pops up every now and then, and it's hard to kind of adjust to that new reality when somebody you know and love has passed. You know, they're just not coming back. And it sucks to sit there and say, well, you know, I'll just, you know, try to distract myself with something else. It sucks to do that, but I feel like a lot of the times that's kind of all you can do. And that's kind of where I'm at right now with life. Just trying to get by, working on, I'm hoping to get this YouTube channel back up and running. I'll go over this later, but I want this next year to be really good for the channel, as in I want there to be actual content that I'm gonna make, probably stuff like this where it's me kind of recording and having a conversation, maybe it's like some skits here and there. I don't really know the full details of it, you know, that kind of depends on the availability of other people, but all in all I feel like it's possible, and sometimes that's all you really need is hope for something. If it's possible, that's the best thing you can have, I think. But it takes a lot out of me when I look back on all of those old videos on this channel before this one, and I think to myself, you know, these are really bad. like these videos are really bad. But they're out there. I made them with me and my friends, and I can look back and I can laugh about all the things that happened and, like, behind the scenes stuff that I remember. Those videos are windows into the past that I'm super grateful for, but at the same time, it's like, I would never make those videos today because they're bad. Like, they just suck. Like, my ego would get in the way of that. And I think that, like, I've wanted to get back into making videos for so long that I just haven't done it because of my own perfectionist qualities, and I want to get rid of that. I don't know if I can get rid of all of it, but I want to get better at just making something and putting it out there. You know what I mean? Like, I want to make videos again. Regularly make videos again. And I know it's been a while since there's been a video on this channel. I mean, not counting the podcast, which I'll get into that in a second. But, like, the most recent video was, I think, 2021. That's almost maybe 2.5 years ago since it came out, and the actual video, the most biggest chunk of it was like, that was filmed like before, like 2020. That's how long it's been since there's been a video on this channel, and it's hard to kind of fathom that for me. I like to call myself like a content creator, but I've spent this whole year doing nothing. And I want to change that, which is, you know, that's why we're here today. As you can probably tell, this is not a scripted thing. Like, I kind of have like an outline on my laptop right there, but for the most part, this is just me talking to the camera. And, yeah, that's kind of how this is going. I guess this is kind of a vlog. I've had an idea for a long time of making a vlog series, and I think that's what I'm going to do. But I don't know, it's hard to think of things to do, because I feel like just sitting here and talking, you know, it can be boring. Like, who's going to watch that? But then I think back to the podcast. When I was making that podcast back when I was still in school, I remember for the assignment, one of our teachers, or actually the teacher of the class was like, you know, you got to make sure you know who your intended audience is for your podcasts, talking to the class. And when I tried to answer that, you know, everybody was like, oh, it's going to be for this group of people. Oh, you know, people who like, the college, people who like tattoos, whatever the podcast was about. But for me, I kept thinking, this podcast, I'm making this for my friends. You know? I'm not expecting anybody to watch or listen to this other than my friends. And that's kind of where I am with this. There's no real intended audience here, except for my friends. And even then, really, this is for me at the end of the day, because it's a vlog, just talking about my life and stuff. I guess what I'm trying to say is this video and the next videos that might come out, they might not be your cup of tea, and that's okay, because at least they're being released on the channel. That's kind of where I'm at. Having said that, I have to go take those freaking shoes back to Jason, so let's go.
Shit, my shoes.
Merry Christmas.
Oh shit, my shoes. Thanks, Casey.
Why did you say that twice? Okay, so how exactly did you leave your shoes, like, in my apartment? Like, did you drive home with no shoes on? Like, is that...
Dude, I'm a fucking idiot, but I'm not that stupid. No, when we went on that, that hiking trip, I think I just left them at your house. So I switched shoes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because I was thinking, like, logistically, like, it makes no sense, but...
Yeah, I'd like to think I'd notice if I drove home
fair
without
enough,
shoes.
Fair enough, yeah.
By the way, you feeling all right? You look a little down.
Yeah, I mean, it's... You know, it's the holidays.
Yeah.
Holiday blues and all that. You don't feel bad around the holidays? Not bad, but like...
Well, I mean, like, I try and see it as sort of a... You know... Maybe it'll be better, right? I like to see Christmas or this time of year as just sort of... goodwill towards your fellow person and, hoping that, despite however rough the year was, it'll be better, right?
Yeah.
I don't know. It was speaking of, would you come to the party tonight?
Maybe. I don't know. It's, I don't know if I'm in the mood for it, you know?
Well, if you do decide to, I think Chris and Evan are coming in. It'll be eggnog.
Eggnog.
Ooh. I can spike it if you want.
You know what? That gives me a nice idea.
What?
I'll tell you later, but yeah, I'm gonna head out.
Oh, okay. Party's at 5.
Thank you.
No problem.
So for a long time, I wanted to do like a cooking video of sorts. One idea that I had for a couple months actually was cooking like a salmon dinner that I like to make every now and then. Sort of like a tutorial, just something, you know, some video idea, like a prompt. I was gonna do that today, but it's not really Christmassy. So how about some eggnog instead? It's kind of a risk, because eggnog is something I've never made before. Really, I've never drinking it before. So hopefully it'll taste good. I don't actually know if it will until we try it, but I think that could be something fun. You know, eggnog, it's Christmas. Let's make some eggnog. So I have a recipe pulled up on my laptop. I'll read you the ingredients. Alright, so we're looking at 6 large egg yolks, 1/2 cup of granulated sugar, I don't know what that word is, 1 cup of heavy whipping cream, 2 cups of milk, 1/2 teaspoon of ground nutmeg, 1 pinch of salt, 1/4 teaspoon of vanilla extract, ground cinnamon for topping it, and optional alcohol. But if you know me, that ain't optional. We're getting drunk tonight, boys. You also will need, obviously, like a saucepan, a whisk, like tools and stuff like that. Or utensils, I mean, not tools. Spoons, you know, the usual. I don't actually own a whisk, though, so I'm going to have to buy one. But everything else, we're going to have to go to the store to get, because I don't think I have any of that. Actually, I might have the milk, but that might be it, I think. Yeah, I think that's probably it. But again, this is new to me. It should be fun. It's new to me, I've never done this before. So we're in this together, guys, we're in this together. We're just going to... I don't know, We're just going to try this and see how it goes. Well, off to the store. Let's go. All right, guys, we're going to go to Walmart, because that's where I'm at in life, I guess. Let's go to Walmart. Now, today is Christmas, you know, so it shouldn't be too crowded, knock on wood, but... We'll see when we get there, but I don't think it's gonna be that crowded, so let's do it. Okay, guys, just made it to Walmart. Look at this. It's like everybody and their mother decided to freaking just pull up all of a sudden. Look at that. Merry Christmas. It's kind of a crummy looking day, actually, but. All right, here we go. Thank you. All right, guys, I'm back. I hate going to Walmart so much, man. But we got everything we need. We're gonna go back to the apartment and we're gonna get started. So let's go. All right, so we're back. So I got all the ingredients laid out. We're gonna get started here in a second. Let me show you the ingredients. So I went over these already, but just so you remember, got some eggs. We need 6 eggs, so I got 6 right here. Almond milk right here. The recipe didn't say almond milk specifically, but that's kind of my preferred choice. I imagine you can probably use your own, whatever you prefer. Heavy whipping cream. Got ground nutmeg right here. Back here we got the salt for the pinch of salt, which it's a lot more than a pinch, but you can use that for other recipes later down the road. Granulated sugar. Pure vanilla extract. Ground cinnamon. And then here's the alcohol. So I'm just going to use Kahlua for this because Walmart doesn't have a huge selection. Plus, I already had that here. The recipe doesn't say what specific brand of alcohol to use. I don't know if this will be any good with the Kahlua, but there's not a whole lot in there, so it shouldn't affect it too bad. Plus, it's still rum. I think the recipe said rum, brandy, bourbon, stuff like that. So we'll see how that goes. And then after we're done, we'll have Ready Whip, and then little cinnamon sticks for the finishing touch. Now, if you were paying attention to the montage, you saw that I got pre-made eggnog. We are going to taste this and the homemade eggnog side by side as a little comparison to see which one's better. But yeah, that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Yeah, that's all of our ingredients, so here we go. All right, we're gonna get started. But before we do, we need 2 things. Ta-da! We got our chef's hat on and the Kiss the Cook apron. So here we go, we're gonna get started. Okay, so we've already run into our first snag. I'm kind of a moron and I didn't realize we need a large bowl. The recipe says medium, I'm looking at it over there. The recipe says medium bowl. So I'm gonna use this pot right here for stirring or like mixing stuff around. Not actually a bowl, it's a pot, but it'll still work anyway, so. With that out of the way, the first step is we need to whisk the egg yolks and sugar together in a medium bowl, which is gonna be this, until light and creamy. I'm gonna move this camera around a lot, so bear with me here. So in here, let me get the stuff. All right, sugar and eggs. I'm dragging the trash can over here for the egg shells. And then this is gonna be for the milk and the stuff. You'll see what I mean in a second. All right, let's get started. Crack these eggs. One of them. You know, eggs I feel are pretty good. I like eating eggs. Cooking them is like super easy. Never had too much of a problem with cooking them. I'm not a huge fan of scrambled eggs. I used to like those more when I was a kid. Sometimes these are hard to crack, so. Pinch right there. There we go. 3 of them down, 3 more to go. I'm gonna wash my hands again after this one. So far, so good with the cracking. There's no eggshells in there. At least not that I noticed. Four, five, and here's the sixth one. Watch me screw this one up. Come on. Right, there's six of them. This is what the eggs look like in there. Six of them. Oh, push it down. Do this over the sink real quick. Alright, now with that open, we need half a cup. So here's a little measuring cup. I'll show you guys here in a second what it's looking like. It's pretty good. Okay, so put that in there, ready to dump, pour it in. That's what it's gonna look like. You guys can see that. It's hard with this thing. And we're gonna whisk it around until it said, let's see, light and creamy. Just take the whisk and just like that. This does not look good at all, but hopefully it won't be too bad once these yolks start to break. I hope you're supposed to break these yolks, because I don't know how you would do this without it. I imagine this would be easier with like an actual, you know, bowl and not this pot, but it is what it is. Yeah, hopefully you guys can see that. Yeah, it looks like it. It's hard to film it myself, but I have a better setup. I'll work on that. Yeah, just keep spinning it around. Looks pretty creamy to me. It's just not that appetizing. But we haven't really started yet, so we'll leave that right there. And we're gonna move on to the next. Next step. Alright, so our next step is in a saucepan right here, over medium-high heat, combine the cream, milk, nutmeg, and salt. Stir often until mixture reaches a bare simmer. I already put the salt in there. If you guys can see it, it's down there. So the salt's in there already. It only said a pinch of salt. I didn't want to put too much in there. We're going to need, let's see, 1 cup of the cream. So here's this bad boy right here, Pyrex. 1 cup of cream. Let's open her up. How much is actually in here? I didn't think about that. 1 pint. About took everything out of it. I should have put that through. Just 1 cup of the cream. Who doesn't love cream? Heavy whipping cream. Alright. Anyway, we need 2 cups of the milk. I should have shaken that first. Shake that bad boy up a little. Alright. with it. Just about enough in there. One half teaspoon of ground nutmeg. Pour that in there. Alright, well, this is turning into a mess already, and we just started. So, and it says stir often until the mixture reaches a bare simmer. So, yeah, this little wooden guy right here. Here's what it looks like. Actually, let me cut it up. That'd be a bad idea. That's what it looks like. Stir this around. It's not mixing that well just yet. Imagine we're probably mix a little better when it gets hotter. Freaking bug in here. It's looking like that right now. It's browning a little. So we'll keep doing this until it reaches a good simmer. Once it does, we have to start taking the... Here's where it gets weird, right? So you remember the raw eggs that are like mixed around right now? We have to take spoonfuls of this creamy milky mixture, take spoonfuls of that and put it into the egg and whisk it around a lot. And then when it's whisked and nice, we put it back into this saucepan, eggs and all. So that's kind of the weird part. Wish this nutmeg crap would work a little better. So it's starting to simmer a little. So let's do the tricky part. Take a spoon, and we are going to remove spoonfuls of that milky mixture right here and put it in the whisked yolk and sugar. Let's do that. Don't spill any. And it does say to whisk vigorously, which I will do. Now it's starting to mix a little better, it looks like. Looks like most of it's getting in there. Not a whole lot of milk left. Keep this one around. And here's what it looks like, alright? So that was the eggs right here. So it's getting very creamy. It looks more eggnog-ish. So it looks like we're getting somewhere. Alright. Whisking that around. Let me check. My laptop keeps turning off on me. It says, once most of the hot milk has been added to the eggs, pour the mixture back into the saucepan on the stove. Alright. That's what we're gonna do. Making a mess here. That. So we're gonna see how this goes. Hopefully this doesn't... There we go. Alright. It says, whisk constantly for just a few minutes. Alright. I'm pretty excited to try this. I don't know how it'll taste. I'm not a huge eggnog person. I know I have friends who are, family who are. I've never really gotten into it, but maybe this will spark the change, you know? Maybe this will be the change that finally makes me an eggnog connoisseur. Or maybe it'll taste better. terrible, and I've never tried again. Only time will tell. I'm just whisking this around. Looking pretty good. IMO, in my opinion. Sorry the setup's not that great, guys. I'll try to figure something out. Yeah. Stern. We're almost at time. Should be good with that. Alright, so we're gonna remove it from the heat. Turn that off. Place it over here. We're gonna stir in the vanilla extract and the alcohol. So, one quarter teaspoon of the vanilla extract. So let's get that. Oh, come on, man. I wonder how potent this is, because it's only asking for like a tiny bit. Oh, too much right there. Dump that in. We're gonna take a quarter cup of the Kahlua. I'm gonna put that in there too. Freaking cap. Can't get the cap off. Alright. Quarter cup. Not a whole lot, but you don't want too much in there anyway. That much. Gotta dump that in. Alright, and we're gonna stir it all together in this wonderful, delightful mixture. Mixing that around. I'm excited to see how it tastes. Now, you're supposed to have it chilled. So the next step is actually pouring it through a strainer and into a pitcher or some kind of container to put in the fridge, which is what I'm gonna do. Alright, stirred it around some more. We're gonna pour it down into this. I'm using this over the sink. So, I don't know what the purpose of the strainer is necessarily. Alright, it's whisking its way through. So here's our eggnog right here. Oop. Ta-da! It's all in there. We're gonna pop the lid on. Spill something here. Pop the lid on. We're gonna put it in the fridge so it can get chilled, and then we'll go from there. So I'm actually gonna turn the camera off for a while now. I'm gonna try to clean up a little bit while it's in there chilling. I'll come back in maybe an hour and we'll give it the taste test. All right, BRB. All right, everyone, we're finally here. It's chilled off a little bit. So, it's time for the taste test. Here we go. So, as you can see, I have two cups. This one is the homemade one that you saw me make. This is the store-bought. And I put some whipped cream in there, some ground cinnamon, and then a cinnamon stick in both of them. Alright, so we're just gonna, let's dig right in. So this is the one that we made. This is the homemade recipe. Let's give it a taste. You smell the cinnamon. much whipped cream. Huh? I shouldn't have been into that. Ugh. I thought it was edible. I don't think I'm supposed to do that. Okay. Ignoring that cinnamon stick. It's not bad. Pretty creamy. I'm like, not in love with it, but it's... If it was colder, I think I'd like it more, but it's... Even then... Really creamy. You can taste the eggs. I mean, it's eggnog, so I would assume that's how it's supposed to taste. Overall, not bad. Let's give this one a taste. See how this one is. I hate to say this, but that might actually be a little better. I don't know that because it's colder. It was store-bought. But it just feels like it has more of an aftertaste to it. Whereas this one, again, it's not bad. But this is, if you don't want to make it homemade, you're not confident in your cooking skills, this is not a bad option. Neither are terrible, but the store-bought might actually have the edge. Which is interesting, because it's usually the other way around. Yeah, I think that about covers it. I think. Let me try it again, just to make sure. If that was cooler, like more chill in terms of temperature, that might actually be a little better. But I don't know though, that's pretty good. That almost has a hint of like, this one's a little, it tastes creamier. Again, I don't know if that's because of the temperature. I'm not an eggnog person, so I don't know. Put your thoughts in the comments below. Let me know what you think, because I'm actually interested to hear. You know, which one's better? I don't really know. This is a tough call. I would say I'd give this probably maybe a 6 out of 10. This I might give like 6.5, maybe 7 out of 10. It's not... Not amazing, nothing like that, just straight up, you know, it's not bad, not really my kind of thing, but that's okay. If you love eggnog, maybe you would have something more to say.
Before I close off this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about my plans for 2024. So I know I talked a little bit about how 2023 sucked, and part of that is because I didn't actually really make anything that year. I think if I make things consistently throughout the year, I'll feel a little better. And part of that has to do with my plan for this coming year. I want to make 12 videos
before the end of 2024. That's about one video per month. It's definitely doable, but it's going to be hard because of my own motivation, running out of ideas, trying to think of new things to do, time management. Having said that, it's not impossible. Like I was saying earlier, the possibility that it can happen is sometimes all you need. And I want to keep this momentum going. I know this was the Christmas special, but I think this kind of personal chat, this vlog format kind of thing that has been going on, I think that's kind of what I'm going to stick around with. Maybe some skits here and there, like I was saying. It's possible. But for the most part, I feel like, this kind of vlog-esque idea that's going on, I think that's what I'm going to really be doing a lot of this next year. I want to see this done. I want 12 more videos by this time next year. 12 videos. It's possible. I know it is. Well, I would like to wish everyone a Merry Christmas. I am going to go to a Christmas party. We'll see how that goes. Have a good night, and Merry Christmas.
Hi, Casey.
Oh, hey, Kroon. It's been a while.
Yeah. You look good.
Thanks, man. Yeah, you do too. What are you doing here?
Just wanted to stop by and say Merry Christmas to you. It's been a rough year, you know?
Yeah, I know.
Well, if you're ever feeling bad, don't hesitate to reach out.
Okay. I'll keep that in mind.
I love you, Casey.
Love you too, man. Let's make 2024 a good year.